It's time for another 2-minute tech tip.
My name is Geert-Jan Wielinga. I'm a member of the OracleJet community. In this 2-minute tech tip, we're going to learn how to embed a tree into a dropdown in order to select items within the dropdown. We showed how to add a list to a dropdown and also how to add a table to a dropdown together with, for example, sorting in the table. But did you know that you can also add a tree to a dropdown, as can be seen here? Providing these kinds of features inside of a dropdown can be really useful for presenting complex arrays of data. And so in this tip, we're going to learn how to work with trees inside of dropdowns. How to do this you will not find within the select single section of the cookbook. Instead, where you need to go is to the next section about selecting many. And in there, right at the end, you'll learn about the tree data provider and how it can be hooked into the select many component to display a tree within a dropdown. Here are the previous two examples showing how to use OJ Select Single with, in this case, a list or with a table. Simpler than that is how to use a Select Menu component. And in there, you use the Options property to set your tree data provider. I have some basic data hard-coded right here and copied directly from the cookbook, which I use to populate the tree data provider, which again, when set on the options property, presents that data as a tree within my component. In this case, I'm using an OJ Select Menu because that supports this functionality. Alternatively, as you saw previously, you could use a list within a dropdown or a tree within a dropdown. A dropdown is far more than a dropdown when you are using OracleJet.
Was that a good tip?
I'm happy about it.
We want your opinion. Thanks for watching and stay tuned.